moment she got there, touchdown into Florida, she was already in my bed and Jack walked in on us.
So you were making out with Jack Doherty's girlfriend.
She's playing the game, bro. Like, homie hopped to Jack right away, whatever.
Does everyone like each other? Do they like Doherty? Oh, or
bro,
how is it?
I'll air it out, bro.
Welcome back to the It Is What It Is podcast, the number one podcast in all of the nebula. And today, we have quite possibly the juiciest, maybe the most expose episode in It Is What It Is podcast history. We have a very, very special guest. He's worked with anyone you can think of. He has worked with them. I'm talking Jake Paul, Mr. Beast, Haley Berry, Marshmallow, Ireland Boys, literally everyone you can think of. He's worked with them. He's accumulated over 100 billion views. Yes, billion with a B worldwide. This guy is usually behind the camera, but today he's taking his talents in front of the screen to expose everything and everything in the industry. And most infamously, he has worked with Jack Doherty. He basically revived his whole career. And man, we're getting into it today. We've held a lot back from talking about Jack Doherty. And I know you have some insane stories that we were talking about off camera. And we were like, yo, should we run it on the podcast? And this is it. The one, the only, Matthew JGL. Welcome, bro. Welcome, bro.
I'm glad to be here right now. And this is where it all goes out because it's some valuable stuff, I will say.
Some crazy things. And just to let you guys know, we've known Matt for a while, actually. We met when we moved to LA in the Bud's house with Jack Doherty. That's how we met each other. We all share faith, and also like our mindsets are all similar, the way we film and how we do everything. So we all connected.
Yeah, so I met Jack first, and I knew who you guys were, obviously. Like, I was always on YouTube. But I met Jack at Playlist when I was working with Just Maiko. He's also someone I worked with that got him from 3 mil to 50 mil. He's the guy that lost the Jarvis. If you guys, there you go, now you know who he is. So yeah, back to Jack. So back to Jack. So I always told myself I would never work with Jack because he's just such a crazy person. So like, I'd rather just keep him as a friend. Even that was just crazy enough as it is already. But yeah, I always told myself I'd never work with him. And then eventually it happened. Even with the whole, you know, OF stuff.
We're going to get into that.
Should we give a little bit of backstory,
backstory
into JGL, how he got into filming with all these big names, how you lived with Jake Paul in the Team 10 house in Calabasas.
How you literally filmed for Mr. Beast while you were still in high school, bro.
Well, not film, edited.
Oh, edited.
Yeah, no. So yeah, it really started my junior year of high school. Mr. Beast made a tweet saying, help me with video ideas. So I joined his Discord. There was like 50 other people in it. Everyone was just ear raping and just like saying all this crazy stuff. And I was the only one actually giving good video ideas. So all I heard was doo-doo. And then it was just me and him in the call. And he was like, hey, this is what we're going to do. I'm going to give you things to do and I'm going to pay you. And then I was like, all right, bet, let's do it. It lived for like about 2 to 3 months. After that, I graduated high school, then moved in with Jake Paul, was with him for like 6 months.
No, but bro, slow, wait. Yeah. Yeah, you got so much, bro. Because when we were talking about it off camera, you have so many stories, bro.
Yeah.
And like the people want to know. I don't think it's bad. Like, we can wait on the Jack Doherty stuff because that is the main juice.
It's coming,
juice.
Guys. If that's why I clicked on the video, just trust it's coming. Also, part of my voice, I lost it.
Yeah, it actually is kind of funny because the interactions that I've had with Mr. Beast, he had like 300K at the time.
I was about to ask, what was he at? Yeah.
Yeah. So the way he actually like even got my number and everything, I already had done a few things for him. Like, I had to go and count every single plate that Logan Paul broke in his videos so that Mr. Beast can then go and break more plates than him.
You yourself counted that.
Yeah, I was in class just like counting each one. I'd screenshot the thumbnail and then draw like those three plates broken in this video. Watch another video, like skim through it and just like, yeah.
And dude, even tell him about how cool Mr. Beast is, because Mr. Beast told you how much do you want to do.
Oh yeah.
And he got to name his price, bro. And
after counting all those plates, Mr. Beast was like, so how much should I pay you? I was like, 70. And he was like, I'll give you 80. And I was like, I probably
80 what?
$80.
Okay.
$80?
Wait.
$80? I thought you were going to say $80,000.
I thought you were too, but that was before he was
$80 per what?
Dude, just
total.
Just
total. Counting
all those plates,
all those
spending all my time watching those videos.
How many hours did it take you to count all these plates?
I shot myself in the own foot, bro. I said 70, he said 80. I realized I could have said like 300.
Bro,
how many plates?
I thought you were going to say K, bro.
Damn. I remember I like tweeted it to him like the exact amount that I had put, but he also had like two other people count it as well, so he found like the actual number, like the average. So he's a smart guy.
That's how it started. But then like, what did you like then continue to do for Mr. Beast?
This one time I like went and found like a bunch of Amazon products that he reviewed. I would also find like old Club Penguin intros and like Minecraft intros that kids would make, and he'd like roast them. It was very short lived, and actually it's really funny because this one time he had me do an edit where I put Jake Paul on a Minecraft gameplay, and it's funny that how I ended up working with Jake. So it's like, I don't know, everything goes full circle, you know.
Almost like manifested that shit.
Bro, the way he's transitioned, it's like he always transitions to like the next big thing, or he makes that person like the next big thing. Obviously, the person that you're with is doing a lot, but it's crazy. You have like the Midas touch when it comes to virality, bro.
Dude, everyone you've worked with has either like popped off while you work with them or after.
Wait, so while you were working with Mr. Beast, though, did that like give you any connections to like then work with more people? Like, or how did you get to then after high school? Like, what happened?
Honestly, no, that like the connection from Mr. Beast to Jake had nothing to do with each other, like literally nothing. So, Mr. Beast was all through Twitter. I just like saw him tweet, boom, met him that way. And then that just died off at a point. And then my friend Marcos Guerrero, super cool dude. He's actually Jake Paul's day-to-day assistant right now. He told me when I was in my junior year of high school, he was like, bro, like get good with the camera, learn how to use a camera. I was already editing at the time, but he wanted me all well-rounded. So I did pick up a camera. I got good with it. And then by the time I graduated high school, he just said, hey, like, I want you to come out here. I want you to, like, do some Team 10 Uncut stuff, help Jake with his vlogs, help stuff with people in the house. Like, I was doing so much, bro. Like, I was going crazy, like, literally,
they were working you,
bro. Like,
but you were
I
like
never
the
sleep.
Like the new intern, like the new guy.
Yeah, and so like I felt like
yourself.
I had to go crazy. Like, Jake even did like a whole video, like flying out my ex and like getting her back with me, and just call. And I was called McLovin at the time because like they said I looked like a McLovin. I don't see it, but I don't see it.
But back then, though, low key, bro.
Get where your glasses at.
So right out of high school, you just flew Jake and them just flew you out.
Yeah, it was pretty quick. Like they had fired some people and they needed to make up for it, so they like gave me like the role of three people almost. Like it was pretty nuts. Like,
really? So you were cooking,
I kept up with it.
And then you worked there for how long did you work with Jake for?
6 months. He had a fight in Miami, and that's where I'm from. So once we went to this fight, I remember after the fight, it was just kind of like a mutual thing where I just stayed back and he went back to LA, and at the same time, Just Maiko, like the TikToker, he had like 3 million followers on TikTok. And he hit me up asking to like if I could be his videographer and whatnot. And I accepted it because why not? Like, he was a cool dude, 3 mil. And I thought I could do a lot with that. And we ended up going to the Hype House almost every day. Like, we went out to LA in an Airbnb. We were trying to get a house out there. So I got to see how it was at the Hype House, like Charlie D'Amelio, all that stuff, Addison. Like, I see how they are off cam, you know.
What is that?
How
like?
Are they off
how
cam?
Are they like?
That's your.
Oh,
like, they seem like
actually,
nice people.
Honestly, bro.
They seem like nice people.
Keep it down. Yeah.
I don't care. I'm going to let this one out, bro. Addison Rae. Dude, so.
Dude,
first time.
Matt is not holding
dude,
back today, bro.
This.
He's been waiting. He could have gone on any pod.
We didn't hear this 40 years ago.
He could have gone on any pod, bro. You could have gone on any pod. And shout out to you for coming through for the boys. I just want to say that before we get into more.
Dude, so I met Addison Rae when she had like 300 followers on TikTok.
300?
300,000. Yeah.
Because when you said 80, Mr. Beast is like.
Yeah. So she had 300,000 followers on TikTok at the time. And Peyton introduced her to me when we were at the Team 10 house. So this was a while ago. Like, she was not Hype House anything. So we're at the Team 10 house. There was a party at the time. And Peyton introduces me to Addison. She's like, hi, this is Addison. Addison, this is Matthew, whatever. And I'm like, hi, nice to meet you. Super butterfly personality. Like, hi, I'm Addison. Like, super nice, everything.
Like how you think she would be.
Yeah, like, super. And I was like, oh, she's a sweet girl. Like, cool. And I don't think much of it later on. 6 months go by. And then I'm at the Hype House working with Just Maiko. And there was this, like, choreography that they're, like, practicing for in the bathroom for BTS because the guy I was working with, like, was teaching them it. And Addison was late, first off. And when she got there, she was, like, making fun of her mom. And she was, like, laughing about it and, like, looking at everyone for validation. Like, ha, it's funny, right, guys? Like, I'm making fun of my mom in front of everyone.
Like a weird
Yeah,
way?
Like super weird.
I heard their relationship is a little weird, her and her
super
like
weird.
Parents, I think.
And also, like, she said hi to everyone else in the room, but, like, at the time I had, like, blondish hair or whatever. Like, it was really, like, died from a prank video. And so she probably didn't recognize me, but she didn't even say hi to nothing to me. Like, just completely ignored me. But little does she know, 6 months ago, she was super nice to me. And then later on, now she got, like, 10-plus million followers, and she don't even know who I am. It's crazy. It's crazy what followers can do to you. Like, really.
Dang.
Sucks.
And then anything else from there?
Dude, there's a lot more than just Addison, but, I mean,
not going
all
in.
That stuff is not as important as, like, the real juice. You know
yeah,
what
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I'm curious
so
to hear about the journey, though. Yeah. So, like.
The journey, yeah. So you go from working there, then you go to Jake Paul. Then what was the next move after that? Because
so, yeah.
Everything's happening pretty quick.
When I was with Just Michael, like seeing like the
just
hype
Mike,
house, all
just
that stuff.
Michael is
Michael Lee. Michael Lee, the guy with the beanie, with the little brother with the beanie. You've definitely seen his videos before.
The elevator thing.
He is one of the most viral. I think it's one of the most liked.
Yeah, so I actually.
The escalator video is the one. If you've ever seen them dancing on the escalator, he basically started that whole entire trend.
Yeah, yeah. Just Michael was the dancer that did all that stuff. And like I was the one to be able to film that bad boy. But within the same week, we got the first and second most liked video on TikTok, which was, like, insane to me. Because, like, Hype House didn't get that yet. You know what I mean? Like, yeah. I did it with a phone and an escalator and a dancing kid. You know what I mean?
We'll,
like,
we'll pop up the video. You've definitely seen this if you've been on TikTok back in the day.
Yeah. And then Bella Porch took it.
With Bella Porch, yeah.
Yeah.
M to the B.
My gosh. Actually, they wanted me to run her YouTube, and I denied it. Because I was like, nah, he's my boy. Like, he's never going to do me dirty. Like, I'm going to stick with him. And they wanted me to run her YouTube channel, and I just completely said no.
And she
crazy.
She had a crush on him, too, bro.
No, she didn't have no crush on me. I don't know what you're talking about. But it is very crazy.
On the low.
It is very crazy how I ended up denying to work with Bella Porsche because I thought Just Michael was just such my boy, you know? Like, my boy. Like, you know what I mean?
Like he was your ride.
Yeah,
your
exactly, right?
Bella Porsche.
Bro, literally probably the biggest TikToker.
Bro.
Sorry, I don't mean to say it like that.
If you're not on TikTok,
But yeah. she went off, and then she also like she went crazy. Like she actually turned into like bigger.
That's what
than
I would
TikTok.
Say. Like
what
when it comes quick, when it comes quick, it goes quick. You have to know how to like maintain it.
She like did. She went. She went more than TikTok. Like she kept going.
What she
I feel
do
like
now?
One of the
what she do now?
Like she'd be doing
music
and all that
music.
Stuff. Like she's like
exclusive. Like whenever you see her, it's exclusive. Like
exclusive
you don't see
content?
Her. Not really. Like it's just you don't see her much. If you see
oh,
her, it's just to promote
like,
a song
oh,
or
yeah.
do something quick.
Like
nothing
Kanye
crazy.
Thing.
Like mysterious
type.
You don't know everything about her versus like some TikTokers. You know, see everything that they do.
But yeah. So back to the fallout with Just Michael, right? So get this. Like this kid, let's just say he's making a quarter mil for a promo, right? And like Got Milk, for example. I don't care. Whatever. You know, quarter mil, right? Just for a 15-second video, he had this back-to-back. We did stuff with Apple, Pop-Tarts, like everything. I would edit these videos. We'd send it to the company. They're like, perfect, no revisions.
Everyone loved
it.
Him because he was so brand-friendly, and he had the little brother.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it was like, so, like, you were telling me
yeah,
about that.
Yeah, so this one day, he ends up getting a call or, like, a message from Austin McBroom saying, this is where it gets fun, right?
Oh,
oh man, you're dude, going off dude. Right now.
Okay, so when I live with Jake, like, I already, like, experienced stuff that happened with Austin and things that I legally cannot talk about. So I knew he was a bad dude. Like, forget this guy. Like, he's not good. So I told Just Michael this. I was like, bro, don't do any business with Austin. He's an evil dude. Like, just, you're not going to win at the end of the day with him. And I remember a week after, I'm having a Bible study in the back, and then he walks into the front door. And
Michael Lee?
Austin McBroom. Austin McBroom walks in through the front door, and then Michael goes and talks with him in the theater room. And I'm like, well, I don't know what's about to happen, but it's about to be bad. And so, whatever, the night goes on, the people from the Bible study leave, Austin McBroom leaves, and then he comes to me, and he's like, yo, bro, Austin has this super fire contract, like the super fire deal for me. And he wants me to fight FaZe Rug. Said Rug at first.
Oh, dang.
He said, I want you to fight FaZe Rug. And the signing bonus and how much he actually made for the fight was nothing compared to what, like, he makes normally.
Did you say the offer? What he was offered?
Screw it. It was 400K for the fight, and it was 60K signing bonus. He never got the actual money from the actual 400K.
Honestly,
just got
6K. That's a lot of money, but for him making 250 for, like, a 15-second Pop-Tart
exactly,
promo is like,
bro. So
you know what I'm saying? You do two Pop-Tarts yeah. and you make a little more.
He was trying to,
I used the whole box.
Yeah, he was trying to deliver this contract to me. Like, he was trying to tell me about the contract that Austin gave him in, like, a good way. Like, he was trying to be so optimistic about it. And I was like, dude, no. I was like, literally, no. Like, first off, don't do this because it's Austin McBroom. And second off,
Phase Rug, low-key,
Phase Rug.
That's easy back.
Even with Phase Rug, I told him no, right? Dude, whatever.
Come on,
so,
tell him yes.
And then he ends up telling me, he ends up telling me, after I said no, I already signed it.
In that moment?
In that moment.
He had no manager, no one look over
then
it.
Then talk to his mom, then talk to management, don't talk to me.
Wow.
Just signed it.
Austin McBroom, and he was young. How old was he at the time?
Michael? Michael?
Yeah. Like 19?
20? 18? Something like that.
Was he 20? Okay.
It's
just like weird for Austin McBroom to do that and like kind of take advantage.
Dude, he definitely took advantage.
Like,
saying
so weird.
Saying Rug and then switching it with Jarvis is crazy.
Because Jarvis and Rug, those are two different beasts in there. Like, Rug is a beast when it comes to YouTube, but like Jarvis is way more built.
Can we
you
put
know?
A side-by-side picture of him on here?
That's like saying like, that's like promising, oh yeah, you're going to fight Ricky and then you fight Nick. Like even more
more different.
Like Darren,
yeah,
Darren
way different.
Dave versus Nick.
I wouldn't. Yeah, maybe I don't know. That's not even a crazy comparison.
Maybe the hotter.
But yeah, what's crazy about it too is that he wasn't training like at all. Like he had 6 months to train. Didn't train until a month and a half before his fight. The reason why he started training was because he got exposed for trying to fake beef.
I saw that. I remember
the
that.
Fake the beef with Jarvis, right?
Yeah. And
like they were calling on the
and
phone.
With that as well, I also said, let's not fake the beef. Let's literally just go get a billboard and just put his face on it, like you punching it, and then let's get Bryce and Taylor and everyone to go look at it. Let's just do that. That's all I said. Let's do that and just run it. He was like, but what if Jarvis doesn't respond? I'm like, bro, what do you mean Jarvis isn't going to respond?
I can't lie, bro. You're like goated
so
with the
dumb.
Ideas, like viral stuff.
Holy
you're goated with the ideas.
His mind works different, dude.
Yeah, like, I could just look at an object, and I'm like, yeah, we could do that.
And keeping it real is key, which I think is why we all, like, respect each other.
Yeah, definitely.
You know?
Real sees real, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, at the end of the day, like, I see it really where my foundation is with God. Like, I've just been growing up in a Christian school and whatnot, and I feel like I know the Bible like the back of my hand. Never read it for myself, but every year learning it in school, I feel like I just know it so well, and that's how I can hear God, and that's how he uses me. That's how I'm able to work with all these people, generate billions of views, because Matthew is translated to gift from God, and that's what I feel like I am, is a gift from God, and I'm here to spread his good news. So
all right.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Amen.
Yeah.
Yes, bro. That was good.
Yeah.
I wanted to say this, though, because, like, you've gotten, like, billions and billions of views, which is, like, that's hard to do, right?
Mm-hmm. On track for a trillion.
Honestly, yeah.
Yeah. Honestly, soon.
Like,
yeah.
And also, we forgot to mention, but Matthew started his own YouTube channel. What is it?
Matthew Gonzalez.
Six months ago?
I started it May 1st, and I now just hit 1 million subscribers.
Like,
under
yesterday.
A year.
Yesterday, bro.
Congratulations, bro.
Yo.
A million subscribers under a year.
Are you doing mainly, like, short content? Or are you doing
shorts.
Like, oh, okay, cool.
I only have 4 long-form videos, and none of them have over 10,000 views. So that's crazy. That's, like, really insane.
Yeah.
Like,
But for the people at home that, like, maybe they're wanting to get into, like, content creation or they have their own channel going, like, is there any advice or tips that you have to, like, making or, like, what's the best way to go? Shorts,
I feel like,
right?
Shorts is, like, the best way to go because you want people to subscribe to you and, like, see what your niche is about. See, like, what's going on so that when they switch your long form, it's not, like, random. Like, if I'm doing my, how long does it take for a phone to die? And then I go to my long form and I'm like, dude, like, I just, like, love, like, some random, like, I'm just talking about some random stuff. You know what I mean?
Yeah,
like, it just doesn't match up. You have to keep it consistent. Like, so, honestly, you also got to do it if you really love it. If you don't love it, you're not going to succeed as much as you feel like you will.
This guy loves it, dude.
Yeah.
This guy.
He lives and breathes, bro. Yeah. The way he gets literally, like, so... His passion is infectious.
I see him popping. I can't say it, but...
Like, bro, his passion is... Bro, that's what we were talking about in the other podcast. It doesn't matter what you do, and I feel like you feel this the same way about anyone that you work with, too, as long as you're passionate about it.
Yeah.
Passionate, it beats, like, anything else, because you're going to keep going. Like, this guy will not get tired. If he really loves something, he'll just do it, bro.
Yeah,
that's key.
Yeah, no.
Like, it turns him on.
Yeah, I was going to say, when he sees, like, a new camera or something, or, like, some new editing software, he pops like a little chub.
Yeah, the reason why I even got into all of this, like it really goes back to, like, what I wanted to do as a kid. Like, I wanted to be on, like, Disney and Nickelodeon. Like, I wanted to be an actor. Like, that's where it really all started. Like, and I feel like now I'm, like, the new age actor, which is, like, an influencer. So it's so crazy how, like, time goes and things change. And I remember asking my mom, like, can I, like, find a way to get on this show. Like, I want to be an actor. We tried, like, the whole agent whatever thing. She never knew how to figure that out. So I ended up just doing YouTube, like, at 12 years old. And I did, like, Call of Duty trolling videos, like, stupid stuff, like, super cringy. Like, I can never show it today. But I ended up, like, learning how to edit then and failed. I stopped the channel. And then that's where Mr. Beast came into the picture, everything else. And then it just kept going from there. But
it's crazy.
Wait, so after the dancing guy, like, what happened after that?
Well, I was gonna say, keep going with this. I was just gonna say
it's crazy how literally you can meet one person and that can like open all these doors that you never even knew. Like your friend Marco, right?
Marcos, yeah.
He's like boys with Jake Paul, his assistant now, and then I'm sure that opens so many doors. Mm-hmm. You just met so many people.
It does.
Yeah, literally that
like,
one,
think about it, like
that one connection.
I'll be fully honest. I was getting paid $200 a week. I mean, hey, like it makes sense for what it was. You know what I mean? Like I was young. Yeah. Yeah. 200 a week. It was like almost
200 just flat 200.
Yeah. 200 a week.
200? No extra commas.
No extra commas. But nah, it's cool though. Cause like that brought so much, like that was so much more valuable than anything. Like,
but now he's paying you big bucks.
I would have even not gotten paid. Like, honestly, like 200 is cool. I was cool with 200.
But now you just filmed two shorts for Jake Paul.
Yeah,
he just got back from Puerto Rico like a couple weeks ago. Not to jump ahead, but like it has to do with it. So
yeah, so now like my rate is like five times that just for one short. So like it's crazy how like things change. And like not only I was living with him like 4 years ago, but now 2 weeks ago I was at Puerto Rico filming two shorts for him. And those two shorts right now are his most viewed shorts. It's the placing a $10,000 bet on letting my dog place a $10,000 bet, and then also boxing with the Apple Vision Pro, and those two are blowing up right now. All his other shorts are like kind of low in views, but
yeah,
the ones
so
I
it translates. Like, he gets paid because you get the results.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
like it's not like you're just paying and then it
yeah. Whenever I tell people my price, they're like, ooh, like for a short, and I'm like,
I'm not gonna lie though, we did a couple of the shorts, and all the shorts that you did on ours like popped off.
Yeah, because it's like I know it's gonna bring subscribers. Like for example, for Dohertys, we did how to track.
Wait for Dohertys.
Well, I'm not going to go too much in that part, but I did a video where it was like tracking Santa with an AirTag, and I got 1.2 million subscribers on a single short.
1.2 so, like, million subscribers, not views. 1.2 million subscribers from one short video. But he got 10 of those silver play buttons, 12.
And just like what I posted on my story today, like I always say this, like it always takes one video. It really does just take one video. Like if you want to get a million subscribers, I promise you it takes one video. One video.
But you got to swing the bat.
How do you come up with these great ideas? Like, do they just come to you in the shower or like what?
I like to just, you know, sit and like ponder on some like random thoughts. I'll even throw some stuff into ChatGPT. I'll be like, hey, I have this idea. Give me like 10 more similar to this. Make it add a twist to it. And then I don't necessarily get the idea from ChatGPT, but it sparks something within me. So, or even like with a group of people, like I love being in a group of people. I'll like play with everyone's minds. Like I'll say an idea and I'll see how you bounce off of it. And then like we could find something from there.
We came up with when we were driving here yesterday, we came up with one and we said it at the same time.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. The one star, five star. Yeah. Something simple, but it's like so viral, you know, like we just like talking about it. Like
one
randomly
star, five star restaurants. But me and you go like one of us gets an amazing day. The other one gets like a really bad day.
Mm-hmm.
What makes
because like he loves good food and like you're whatever about it.
I love good food too,
bro. And just
he seems like this guy's going crazy. But I love good food too. I'll be in the video. Just give me the five star side.
Like what do you think makes something viral though? Like so what are like some aspects?
When I was with Just Michael, like this is when I learned this, especially in the TikTok world and everything. So back in 2020, I called it viral factors. Like that was like the thing I called it. So in order for your video to really go viral, you have to have these viral factors, and there has to be at least 5 to 7 of them. So first viral factor needs to be the concept. If your concept's not even good, why are you doing it? Like if you're not happy with your concept, change the concept and then do another one. Do one that's viral. The second thing could literally be something that someone says in the video. It just throws everyone off. The third thing could be something that happened in the background. Something fell. No one noticed it, or they didn't notice it.
In the TikTok comments, whenever there's like something a little bit strange or off, like you check the comments, it's always like the top comment.
Like if you weren't wearing comments, if you weren't wearing your shoe for this whole podcast, we didn't say anything about it, everyone would be commenting. Mm-hmm.
Like if I wore one shoe,
yeah,
everyone would be saying that in the comments, and that's probably why this video would go viral. Actually, what's funny about it is that video that I said of Dohertys, of the one that got 1.2 million subscribers, that video, why it went viral was because I did a typo.
Bro, it's crazy. When you mess up, people love to jump on it. Like, sometimes we've spelled stuff wrong on purpose in the video because then everyone will go into the comments and then be like, this is how you really spell it. No.
It works, bro.
And the comments boost the engagement and the algorithm and everything.
I've seen people figure that out, and, like, they do it on purpose now, and, like, sometimes it's, like, too on purpose where you just don't even want to watch the video.
That's,
like,
that's true.
Yeah, it's bad.
Yo, do you get a lot of your ideas?
Wait,
like,
keep going. He has to finish the viral concepts.
Oh, yeah. I would say, too, like, with the viral concepts, it really depends on how much of a punch you're going to give them. Like, and that's why I say it has to have 5 to 7 of them, because if you have, like, 1, 2, 3, 4 concepts or reasons why the video is going to go viral, like, there's just might be a chance no one is interested in whatever it is that you did for it. So having 5 to 7 different reasons why someone can engage with your video is what's going to make it viral no matter what, no matter what you do, no matter what the concept is. Like, I literally say this sometimes, like, I can literally make you taking a crap viral. I swear, like, anything.
I believe it, bro.
Literally anything.
Oh, mine especially,
today.
Bro. Mine are massive.
Oh, my goodness, bro.
You don't even need to put anything on it. Just, like, record the audio, and it'll go crazy.
Dude, through storytelling, you can make anything interesting. So, like, that's what I've learned. And, like, you don't have to necessarily stick with one thing. And, like, niching down, like, that's why my content isn't really niched down. Like, I feel like I can just do a video on, like, whatever.
There's
and
stuff
people
anyone
accept
can
it.
Watch it. You know?
Yeah, pretty much.
It's just, like, virality content.
Mm-hmm. But what was the other thing you asked about? Oh, what happened with Michael?
You were about to say?
Yeah, so it was the fight, really. Everything ended at the fight. So once he fought Jarvis, he only had a month and a half of training. So I can't blame him that he lost.
Hey, I only had 1 month, so.
Damn.
But keep going.
You won. Yeah,
I was more so just crazy. I was just talking about, like, the journey, because I don't even know you, so I really just was just talking about, like, asking, like, how you got to where you are now.
We're getting there.
Oh, we're working there slowly.
Yeah, yeah.
Chapter
so I had to finish off with these other people in order to get where I am now. But where I finished with Michael was he lost his fight to Jarvis, and then I remember he was, like, crying in the bathroom because he lost his fight. I don't care, I'm exposing this. And I told him this. This is what I said. I was like, look, bro, like, as a boy, I was like, look, like, I know this is hard, whatever, but we're gonna go back home and we're gonna get straight to making content. And if you act like nothing happened, nothing will happen. But if you go back home and you act like something happened, you dye your hair like he did, stop posting for 3 months like he did, then everyone's going to think something happened, and boom, now he's a nobody. Like, I'm sorry, but it is what it is. Like
you got messed up. Like Ryan Garcia going crazy after
Ryan Garcia.
And everyone's like, but if you just keep going, it'll pass by. Everything mm-hmm. passes by.
Exactly, yeah. When you dwell on the past for too much, like some people just, like, love dwelling on the past. Like they just love staying in the past.
It brings them dopamine because they relive that moment. And even though they say they don't like it, they do deep down like it. You know when people talk about
it? They live in it
things?
Every day.
Dude.
I feel like I can relate to that sometimes. Like, I'm always having to talk about certain things, and I'm like, I hate explaining it over and over again. But yeah. I guess this will be the last time I explain it, right?
One and done, man.
One and done.
Let's go.
But, like, someone else who lost that same night, Bryce Hall, main event, that's the main fight everyone's tuned in for. He took an L, but he just kept on going. His loss, like, it propelled him even more. And he just kept going, act like it never happened, and he took it on the chin.
He's
not even a boxer, bro.
Dude.
He never claimed
to be,
bro.
What's so ironic about it all is, like, the main reason why he accepted the fight and why he said he really, really wanted to do it, he was like, I just want people to match my name with my face.
Michael
and, dude, yeah. And that's why I feel like
Remember the face, bro.
Yeah, they remember the face now. Yeah, you made
a
dumb mistake.
Bruises on it.
Yeah,
dang,
exactly.
Bro. Yeah, because for the money for him, it wasn't that.
It wasn't.
That,
he didn't care
sense.
About the money. Exactly. Like, he just knew that whenever we'd go out, everyone would break neck. Like, oh my God, this kid from TikTok. But they don't even want to come up to him because they don't know how to say his name.
They don't want to be.
Isn't that crazy?
But like, now they know it's the guy that got knocked by Jarvis.
Exactly.
But it could have been different. Look at Bryce Hall got knocked by Austin McBroom. Bro, probably Austin McBroom is the biggest clown I've ever met. Right behind Jack Doherty.
Most definitely.
Bro, so it's crazy that he kept going, and then he changed his whole trajectory. And I'm not even kidding now. I liked Bryce back then because I knew him, like, off-cam. But, like, online, he's dope, bro. He's, like, funny. Like, I think he's had
one of the
full 360.
Like, out of everyone, I can genuinely say Bryce is cool. Like, everyone I met. Honestly, I was cool at a point with Taylor Holder. Then he got a cold shoulder when he got his heart broken or something, and he started acting weird. I don't know. And then he had a whole thing going on. Yeah, he had so much going on. But he gave me a cold shoulder once. Then there, I was like, all right. Like, I don't care. Like, I really don't care. Like, it's just, like, I'm such a real person. I can come up to a random person and be so genuine with them. But if you, like, don't show me respect, best believe I'm not giving you respect anymore. I don't care, like, anymore after that. I'm respectful, though. But
no, but Bryce is dope, bro.
Speaking of that disrespect, I think progressing towards the Jack Doherty chapter.
I think we're at Jester. There.
Now we're at Jester.
So yeah, after Just Michael, that's when I started being with you guys then. Like, I wasn't working with you guys, but like I kind of was. Like,
we were like hanging out at the crib. Yeah. Like, you were there almost like every night.
Yeah, yeah.
But we were more on just like friends. Like, yeah. We would film some stuff together. Mm. But it was
and
cool.
I would do it for fun too. Like, even Doherty, like I would always have my camera on me, and he loves that about me. Like, I would never charge him or anything. I just love filming. It's funny, you know?
You'd always just be snapping pictures of the boys.
But it was cool to build that relationship with you in that way before, you know, as well, too.
Yeah, no, that house was definitely interesting.
Yeah,
but...
The LA house?
Yeah, while I was hanging out with you guys, that's when I got the opportunity to work with Jesser. They had posted... His girlfriend posted on her story saying that they're looking for, like, an assistant editor. And I swiped up, and I was like, I'm not an assistant editor, but, like, I'm definitely down to pull up and, like, talk to Jesse. And so I pulled up on him. I told him how, like, I'm more of, like, a senior producer. And, like, I've told him, like, the things that I've done. And he was so game for it. I told him my rate, everything. He was like, let's do it tomorrow. Like, let's hop on it right now. Like, let's do it ASAP. So I love – Jesse's one of the best people I've ever worked with, besides you guys, obviously. Like, he's such a pure soul, and, like – any bad that goes towards him should never go towards him because he's such a cool person.
If you guys don't know him, he's basically the guy that does, like, all the sports videos, like, going to 10 NBA games in 50 hours or things like that.
Yeah.
We'll pop up pictures of all these people, too.
So with Jesser, I'm going to lay it out here. It is. So he had some backlash go on with some guy named, like, Mopey or whatever. And, like, Jesse's literally innocent in it all. And, like, I, like, didn't even know anything about it until I met him. So he was stuck at, like, 3 mil for I don't know how long, but he was stuck at 3 mil on YouTube. And when I started working with him, it was just going absolutely insane. Like we passed Cash Nasty. Cash Nasty looked at me and was like, what are you doing for his channel? Like, what? Like, and I was like, I don't know. I'm just making shorts. And now Jesse's sitting at, like, 15 mil. So, like, it's crazy. I stopped working with him when he hit, like, 10. And actually, I didn't stop working with him because I wanted to stop working with him. It's because Jack Doherty stole me from him. Literally stole me from him. Like, once Shorts announced that they're going to start paying creators for short videos, he hit me up right as soon as I got out of the shower, and he's like, yo, I'll give you six figures right now to quit for Jester. Come on,
Jack,
please.
You?
Quit for Jester. Come on, six figures right now in your bank account right now. And, like, all I'm thinking about is, like, I literally cannot work with this kid. Like, he's too crazy. I can't. But, like, the money, this kid. Like, I just, like, left and right on my shoulder. Like, and what's crazy about it all is how I literally basically said no to the money. I was like, I can't. Like, I got to talk to Jester first, all this stuff. And he was like, okay, just send me the bank info, and we'll figure it out later with, like, CPA or whatever. Like, we'll figure it out later.
Yeah.
I send him the bank info, wires it right away. And, like, what?
Full amount, bro. Full amount for the whole
year. No contract,
wired you $100,000 right there without you even signing shit?
Pretty much.
Holy f***, dude. You know what you could have done?
He could have
just dipped.
Yeah, I could have.
But he's a good guy, though.
But I ended up going.
That's respect right there.
So, like, I like saw it hit, and I was like, dang it, you can't really just return that money, that type of money.
Wait, hold up. I got to say, dude, definitely clip that. Clip editor. Definitely clip that.
No, clip all this. We're going to make about 50 to 60 clips from this podcast, I'd say.
Yeah. Keep going. Mm-hmm. This is all in.
Hold on. We'll cut when I start talking again.
No, it's not getting cut. Huh? It's not getting cut.
We'll leave it.
No cut.
Okay, whatever. Where was that?
So you're at Doherty wires you $100,000.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Like, so he wired.
You can't really return $100,000.
Yeah. So I can't really return it. So I had to talk with Jesse, and I was like, "Yo, like, I don't know how to tell you this, but, like, I just got sent six figures into my bank account, and I now have to go work with Jack Doherty." And they were like, "Well, I mean, we can't outdo that. So, like, congrats." Like, they were just kind of like, "Damn, like, well, it's
good for you.
Sucks, yeah." Like. And so, like, the whole week that I was there for, like, the last week, Jesse just, like, I was obviously, like, down. Like, I felt bad because it was, like, I liked him. I liked working with him. I wanted to keep that vibe still going, but, like, you just can't return that type of money. So it's like
an NBA.
It was evil. It was really evil. Like, honestly, like, he wired it without me really even saying yes yet. So,
it's
like
a basketball player or an MLB player, and they love the team they're on, but then the other team's like, yo, we'll give you this much more. And you're like, man, for your life, for your, like, for you. It's like,
you know what I look at it like? I look at it like Ronaldo going to play in that Saudi league and getting, like, a bill for a year.
Or Patty Mahomes going to sign with
the Jets.
But
he knew what he was doing giving me that money, though, because, like, it paid off. He has millions on millions on millions on millions now.
Let's get into that. So Doherty sends you the $100,000. You tell Jester, oh, I got to leave. I'm sorry, bro. You know, it's been good, but I'll see you. And then
October 1st comes around. I move back to Florida. I'm from Florida originally, and we are in Fort Lauderdale area. And just wow, like I always like knew that I didn't want to get into this scene. Like I hated it. Like I just was disgusted by it.
OF,
actually, OF. Funny enough,
say OF.
Yeah,
bleep that,
OF. I did say OF. Yeah.
Yeah.
Funny enough, the first day he started it with Zach and Nat, I literally told him the first day. I was like, bro, just let you know, this is the devil's money. Just to let you know, first day. I was the first person to tell him that. And he was like, nah, dude, I'm confirmed. I'm good. Like, I'm chilling. Like, I'm confirmed when I was a baby. Like, da da da. And I was like, bro.
You can't even do that, can't you?
That's not how this works.
You got to be, like, yo, older to be confirmed.
Wait, I got to go pee, bro.
Keep going.
And what's crazy about it is just his mindset on it. He was like, well, like, all I want to do is just, like, scam all the people that, like, the old people that want to, you know, chat with these girls. Like, I just want to scam those. Like, that's what I'm targeting. But when you're trying to target those, you're still going to end up getting all these little kids that are watching these videos. So,
like, almost corrupting them.
Exactly. So when I started working with him October 1st, I took it to myself as, like, I'm not going to make any of the bad stuff. I'm just going to make innocent content with him. And so we'd be making these shorts, and they would be viral shorts. Like, we would think about them to, like, grow his stuff, to traffic these people to his other follow, like, his accounts and stuff.
Yeah.
And,
like, what's some videos that you made that popped off? Like, the Santa.
I did one with him, which is his most viral short, which is Wilson versus Spalding. And that's, like, what I did with Jesse, with Jesser, like, was the whole basketball stuff. And that was an idea that I had for a while. I never did it with Jesse, but I did it with Jack, Wilson versus Spalding, two main basketball brands. Which one will pop first? And at the end, the ball hit the camera. Like, it popped and it
hit the camera.
It looked fake, so, like, how crazy,
bro, yeah,
it was.
It's so viral. So it got, I don't even know how many views it has. It
should do that
it's
with crazy.
I think it's in the hundreds of mils.
Yeah, it's in the hundreds of mils. And that, like, set it off. From there on, we just posted banger after banger after banger. We averaged 1 million subscribers a month. Literally 1 million subscribers a month on his YouTube channel.
I remember you guys were crazy.
Do you remember what Jack Doherty was at subscriber-wise?
Three mil. He was stuck at 3 mil. And word for word, once the subscribers started coming in, he was like, dude, I thought I was going to be stuck at 3 mil forever. Let's go. Like, I remember that vividly, literally vividly. Like, he was so hyped about the fact that he was growing and everything. And so October, we got like 1 million subscribers that month. November, same thing. And then December, we got 2.1 million subscribers.
Holy cow.
Because that's where we did the Santa one, and we also had the other ones cooking. And then so I worked with him for like a total of 6 months. And where it went down, it was pretty crazy. Like, I don't even know where to start with this.
No,
bro.
This,
like,
is an insane, this is, like, bro. Crazy, I remember you talk. We were on the phone back and forth as all this was happening because you were calling me too.
Bro, this is where it goes all salty. Like, this is where it all goes out the window. So we do this LA trip, right? And so we're there for a week. And Sam
Frank, a.k.a. Neon's ex-boyfriend.
Neon's ex girlfriend.
That shit, I don't know, man.
Not even. That fake. Come on, guys. Like, let's get with the program.
I think it was real for Neon, bro.
It was real for Neon, and it was fake for her.
Yep.
So Sam told Jack, hey, I have this friend McKinley. Jack, you should get with her. Like, she's pretty, whatever. You should talk to her. This and that. So we go out to LA, and, like, that was the objective for Jack, to, like, talk to this girl. And doesn't talk to her a single time while we're in LA, at least from what it looked like. And I think I only ever spoke to her, like, once on, like, friendly vibes, like, talking about aliens and stupid stuff. Like, I was not flirting with her whatsoever. And then we end up going back to Florida after all that happening. And she's blowing up my phone, liking all my stories on my face, like, every other story she's liking. She swipes up on one thing. And I'm like, yo, this pretty girl's giving me attention. Like,
this is McKinley.
McKinley. Like, I'm like, she's hot. Man. Like,
which is that's Jack's girlfriend right now.
Yeah,
like, Main thing.
Exactly. And there is another girl in this mix, but, like, I don't want to go too much into that. But, like, me and Mitchie had, like, a little ting, whatever, you know what I mean?
She's the other girl in the house, the other main ting.
Yeah, like, we had a little ting, you know. But
probably, like, McKinley and then okay, Mitchie's, okay.
Yeah, and
Michelle.
Michelle.
And when we were in L.A., like, I guess McKinley didn't, like, because me and Mitchie didn't flirt at all when we were there. Like, we were very serious. And so I think McKinley never, like, knew that, like, me and her had a thing, or because she probably wouldn't have, like, flirted with me if she knew that. You know what I mean? So we go back to Florida, and I just literally cold call her after she's, like, liking all my stuff and swiping up on everything. I just cold call her on Instagram. I'm like, hey, what's up? How are you? Like, how's everything? We're talking for an hour. By the end of the call, I'm like, dang, this girl has a fat crush on me. Like, literally, like, she wants to marry me at this rate. So I get her number.
Yo.
Clout can do crazy things, guys. Literally. So once I get her number, I'll just let you go from here.
You got to give it to Nick.
I don't even need to read these messages.
I read it the other day, and bro.
Are you serious?
You got Nick has to react
Holy
to this.
Shikies, man. You got messages.
Yeah.
Messages, and what are these messages? When do they start? Like right after what you said, kind of?
Yeah.
And keep in mind, the point of the trip was for Jack to talk to her, to recruit her, to be...
It was for content, but like she was in LA, so like...
It was to recruit her, bro.
Yeah, basically.
Recruit her to be a part of Jack's like OF agency.
Wait, so obviously you would know
Let me finish. All right. I mean, I finished now, but like, let me, you know.
I got the messages. Did we get to it?
I think so.
Did we do it? We do it?
I think so. This is like the juice, bro.
Are they actually dating, though? Like Jack and her?
Bro, this is what you're about to hear, bro. You're about to hear what it really is like. You think everything you see on the internet... This is the one thing that we were talking about on the car right here. He said, and this is... Everyone knows this. Not everything on the internet is what it seems, bro. All right. Some people might look happy.
All right, YouTube. Gotta get ready for this, yo. All right. I am about to read Matthew's texts with Jack Doherty's girlfriend, McKinley. All right, Matthew goes... Hopefully I see you this weekend. Little blushing smile emoji. She says, yes, I hope so too. Blushing smile emoji. I'll keep you guys updated. Just got to get the bread up. Then Matthew says, you can easily get that bread up with us. Trust. You don't really have an option. I might have to go over there and steal you.
Aggressive Riz works. Trust. Keep watching.
And then.
Reading.
And then she says, you can come steal me for sure.
No, nowhere did he provoke that. It just, boom.
You can come steal me for sure. It's crazy. And then Matthew goes back, says, filling my tank right now. She says, let me know when you're here. Matthew goes, I got to get a few things before I get there. But just for research purposes, what's your ring size? Okay, buddy. Buddy hit him with that Riz. What's your ring size? That's a good one. All right, she says, oh, perfect. I can easily give you that answer and help you out. I'm a size 8. Okay, so... It's definitely flirty vibes, right?
100%, bro.
I mean, talking about ring sizes and shit. Okay. Okay, perfect. This is Matthew. Okay, perfect. I just needed to have that noted. Have your bag packed and ready when I get there. She said, I'm already packed up. Trust. 2 steps ahead of you. And JGL says, I love a woman that makes my life easier.
I really do. Like.
And then McKinley says this. Here I am. With like an emoji like this. And JGO says, oh, yeah, a heads up. If you keep liking my stories, I might have to give you a kiss. So, all right, there he pretty much, he's straight up saying that you're into her, right? And then let's see if she reciprocates the energy. And she said, oh, my goodness. She said, typed in notes, keep liking his IG stories.
Bro,
yo,
this is crazy.
So she wants you to give her a little smooch.
I wasn't expecting any of this. I literally was not. I barely spoke to her the whole trip. Damn. I didn't. You know, I was letting my boy Jack get some play. I wanted my boy Jack to get some play, but I guess she wanted me, bro. I don't know what to do.
Yo, we'll pop up the screenshots too.
Can we pop up these screenshots?
Hell yeah.
Okay. Dude, she wanted more than a smooch.
Bro. All
right, you'll get there. He's getting there.
Do I keep reading?
You can go whenever you want.
Yeah, you can keep reading.
All right.
But if it's not good, just keep like.
Well, I don't know what to
You could see stuff that like she's saying to me, and you could see like how she's feeling.
Right here, let me know. And then JJR says, keep it up, and I might have to take care of that. And then she said, what? I said I wanted you to take care of it. Oh, my goodness. Okay.
I'm literally remembering all this right now. I'm like, holy shit. Like, this is crazy.
And then JJR says, looks like it's getting taken care of then. She said, I'm happy to hear that. JGL says, everything will be taken care of next time you're face to face. And she said, good, that's what I wanted to hear. All right, so she's about that action.
Yeah, yes. You're about that so action. Much to the point where once she flew in, she was already in my bed. The moment she got there, touchdown into Florida, she was already in my bed and Jack walked in on us.
Wait for that, bro. That's going crazy.
Making out, bro.
Wait for it, bro.
Wait, so you were making out with Jack Doherty's girlfriend.
It wasn't even his girlfriend at the time, but yeah.
You had that before Jack Doherty.
Yeah.
These are legitimate text messages with McKinley, yeah?
You could even call the number if you really want.
No, I'm good. I'm good on that.
Oh, that'd be crazy.
That would be crazy.
That would be nuts.
Should we after?
You might.
After we read all this?
You might. I mean, I don't care.
I wonder what she'd say.
Oh, my gosh. Wait, you should call
she
live.
Doesn't like, she don't like you no more, right? Or like.
Bro.
Use my number.
Go to the bottom of the text messages.
Yeah, you wait till you get there, bro. It's
okay,
crazy.
Okay, all right. And the text messages I'm reading are when? Like, how long ago?
That was like the, from LA to her coming to Florida.
Was this like last May?
This, I don't know. My time.
Wait, I forgot. I can read it right here. It says March. March. Okay. All right. So then, you know, texts keep going. They're texting back and forth a little bit, flirting. And then she says, I literally could not sleep. And then Matthew says, was it because I was on your mind? She says, yes, actually, you were. Then Matthew says, okay, good, same here. And then she says, I love to hear it. All right, so they're flirting back and forth. I'm trying to find some more juice up in here.
A lot of flirting.
There's a lot of flirting. It's just like, you know, I don't want to read too much of the flirting, you know?
Keep going. So when she gets closer to flying back down to Florida. Because this is when she's still in LA and he's back in Florida with Doherty.
Okay.
And at this point, while Nick's looking through, Doherty, what is the vibes with you and Doherty at this point?
So yeah, like when we came back to Florida, I had thought like he was done with this girl because he didn't speak to her once when we were in LA. And just like, really, like he takes so much at ease. How can he even feel feelings, you know what I mean? Like all he cares about is money, so it's like it's not even like he wanted any of that for the right reasons.
That's
but
what I was feeling, and I'll say this too: I don't feel like he doesn't get turned on.
Doesn't
like I don't know how to describe it, but it's like I remember going down there. And this is when he was dating Grace, and we went on a yacht. And man, dude, honestly, I'm saying all this because I hope he does come around one day for his own health and
that's,
safety.
Dude, that's so bad though. Like I don't know if you guys have experience with Adderall though, like it makes you like a robot, dude.
Mm-hmm. Listen to this though. So we're literally going on the yacht, and while Nick's still looking, we go down there. He's with Grace. She wants to go like make out with him and kiss him, and I'm on the yacht with you too.
Mm-hmm.
Really?
Yeah. And this is when we were still kind of cool with Doherty. Like it was like interesting, but it wasn't like bad because he knows. I feel like I'm like in a way we're like his older brothers because we actually do care about him. I feel like not many people do care about how he ends up. Like, everyone would love to see him fall.
Mm-hmm.
I do want him to be okay because, dude, we grew up together at the same time, same, like, YouTube era. Tanner Fox, Tanner Brumgart, Ireland Boys, Moore J. Stewart, like, all of them. And you can see where everyone's going different paths.
He needs guidance.
But we're there, and his girlfriend's, like, trying to, like make out with him, like, have
some. Not like his girlfriend, but, you know.
Or like Grace, whatever.
Grace, yeah.
At the time. And she literally is down there with him, like, just trying to, like, appreciate him. And she comes up, and she talks to me, and Matt was right there, and she goes, yo, Ricky, like, how do I get him to, like, cuddle me or, like, kiss me or, like, and he just won't show affection. And I was like, I don't know, bro. I just don't think.
All right.
I think he cares about other people, but it's, like, a weird way that he cares, though.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely just like Adderall, you know?
Well, he gives people nice stuff and he pays, but it's, like.
I can tell you someone who would cuddle McKinley, according to these text messages that I just found. It's this guy right here.
Whoa.
So she says, all right, so. Now in the timeline, McKinley is about to fly down to Florida to see Matthew and Jack and, like, the house and everything, see what's good with that. And then she
actually, you know what's crazy? Before she even got, like, while she was on the plane, I, like, gave her a heads up, like, hey, I know you're liking me and everything, but just to let you know, Jack wanted to get with you prior to all this stuff. Like, Jack, like that was, like, Jack's goal. And she's like, oh, well, that's fine because I don't even want Jack. Like, I want you. Word for word, so, which is just crazy.
This is crazy, bro.
Crazy.
I didn't know it was like this. Like, I didn't know whose word to believe, but now I'm seeing the text. I'm seeing it for myself right in front of my own eyes.
Yeah, me and Nick had talks about this. We were like, dude, low-key, maybe Doherty's, like, telling some of the truth, and you are, but after, like, seeing it.
Yeah. All right, so JGL says, I can't sleep. McKinley says, you are just so excited to see me with about 5 O's in there. Then Matthew says, the only way I can sleep is if I get you off my mind, and I don't know how that's going to go. She said, I love that. Hee hee. JGL says, so how do I get you out of my mind? I need to sleep. She said, I don't want to leave your mind. So then Matthew says, maybe I need you here. And then McKinley says, you definitely do. that would help. I'll be there. Then JGL says this, cuddled up would help me sleep for sure. McKinley says, I love that. With about, there's about 10 E's in there. I love that. I'd pass out in seconds. And then, this is crazy. McKinley says, by the way, I'm clingy and touchy. Just saying. All right, so the vibes are definitely there. McKinley wants a little bit of that Matthew JGL. Right.
I mean, I guess I'm the cutest one in the groups. Like, I wouldn't blame her. You feel me? Like,
this guy's a funny guy.
All right, all right. So then JGL says, good, keep that energy. She says, I'm keeping it. And then,
some stuff happens.
And then some stuff happens. Some stuff happens.
I can explain before it gets to that, like, last message that's there of, like, me telling her something. So she flies in, right? And she puts her bags into the room that she was going to be staying in. And I was like, hey, McKinley, do you want to look at the pictures that I got of you from L.A.? And then she comes into my room. She gets in the bed with me under the covers. We're just, like, on the laptop, whatever. Very shortly, laptop closes. We're making out. I'm doing some things with her, whatever, you know. And then Jack walks in. He's like, yo, are we going to go get some?
Yo.
And then walks back out. And I look at that. And I look at McKinley. I'm like, I just literally shrug my shoulders. I'm like, And then we just go back to making out, whatever. And then he comes back
in.
Oh,
no.
Dude, it's, I don't know. Whatever. He comes back in, and then he's like, all right, let's go, like, get the stuff that we said we're going to go get. So we're in the car, and he's like, so is McKinley for the gang? And I'm like, I don't know, bro. She was just flirting with me. Like, I'm not going to say no. Like, so he knew, like, where everything was at that point. So really, it was just about, like, is he a man or not? Like, is he going to want my sloppy seconds, and is he going to want a homie hopper? And a lot of stuff went down. Like, so we, at that day, after, like, he walked in and whatnot, we ended up going to Rock Bar, and
I was just there.
Yeah, yeah. So we were at Rock Bar, and I even told McKinley, and I told myself, like, I'm going to, like, keep it subtle and, like, have it so no one really knows, or, like, a fling thing, whatever, because, like, I also know how, like, Mitchie would feel about it, and I know how Jack would feel about it. But, like, after, like, you know, I little, you know, I, like, just
sneaky link vibes.
You know, I was, like, you know, really touchy with her. We're chilling, you know, at Rock Bar.
Dude, Jack and Doherty was actually at Rock Bar when I went.
You saw him?
He was leaving, like, when I went.
You said, what's up?
I don't know.
So when we were at Rock Bar, like, we were, like, feeling touchy or whatever, we're chilling, and I think at a point Mitchie gets there, and she sees that, and then, like, that definitely, like, caught her off guard, because, like, that was probably the last thing she expected. And so from Rock Bar, we were on our way back to the house, and in the Uber, I'm, like, talking Spanish to the Uber driver, because, like, whatever, like, I was speaking to him, and she was like, oh my god, that's so hot. And then she just started making out with me again. Literally, like, lit, like,
in
I'm
the
not
car,
yes.
In the Uber on
I,
the way
I
home?
Have I have a snapshot of her, me and her just making out in the back. Whoa. Like,
play it.
Can we play that?
Let's do it.
Because the people, this is the thing about this. People be lying, but when you show proof, the proof's in the pudding.
Matthew has two phones, by the way.
As real as it gets.
There's another one. Oh, that's right there, yeah.
Like, I didn't when I'm thinking, like, oh, I'm reading what? Fake messages on my phone.
I didn't even realize.
Look, your love handles. Two phones. You look ready? Hey.
Ooh. I've seen the video.
Lit.
Let me see it. Let me try this real quick.
I don't know.
I need to get one of them. That's key for knocking doors.
Well, Matthew is looking.
And it goes on this metal.
It's coming up. Here we are.
Here it is.
And you can hear Jack in the background, too.
Whoa!
He's like,
whoa!
We see? Here we go. Can we pop this up?
Whoa!
Airdrop this to us.
Can we put this on the screen?
I'll take yes.
What?
No, shut the.
You hear him. You hear
I'm
him.
I'm not gonna lie, JGL. You said make out. I'm a little disappointed.
Well, like, you know, that was just for the snap, but we were making out the entire time and whatnot. Yeah, yeah. Whatever. So this is.
Yeah, just keep it real. You know, the people at home are probably thinking.
Yeah. No. Okay. So we end up getting back and, like, whatever. We're chilling. We're still, like, you know. Chilling, and then Mitchie takes McKinley to the room, and then they're chatting, and I'm like, damn, like, it's soiled. So I ended up finding out that, like, Mitchie was telling McKinley that I'm a player, I do this type of stuff, I'm this, I'm that, I'm this. So then once they stopped talking, McKinley came out of the room, and I go to her, and I'm like, hey, like, are you good? Like, everything's chilling? She's like, yeah, we're good, everything's good. And then whatever, go back to making out, and then I didn't really think that, like, you know, Mitchie had said anything too crazy, but, like, I don't know. Who am I kidding? Like, she obviously did. And then so I would blink or get the someone at that comes at the door. Like, I'd go get the door or whatever. Uh-huh. I blink. She's not in my room anymore. She's at Jack's room. And, like, Jack's, like, all trashed. He's, like, trying to, like, just, like, exist. And, like, she's literally just there helping him, like, stay in bed and not fall out of his bed and stuff. Like, literally,
wait,
like,
he was
trashed.
Okay or what?
He was trashed at the time. Oh. Brother, but he was probably miserable. But I don't blame him. It is what it is. You feel me? Like, I don't care what about. But yeah, so like she would like keep reappearing in his room, and like I'd assume she's like homie hopped at that point. And like she's not my girlfriend, so I like grabbed her and I went and I told her and I was like, hey, like if you want to get with Jack, like we share underwear, we can share girls. You feel me? Like I'm cool with whatever. Like da 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 da. And she was like, no, Jack, like no, never. Like trust me, like I like you. Like you have nothing to worry about. Like literally word for word is what she says. So she's telling me one thing, she's telling them the other. And then by the end of that night, I'm getting Jack and Logan telling me, like, bro, you're scaring her, bro. You're this, you're that, you're this. And I'm like, huh? And then so I go and talk to McKinley, and I'm like, yo, like, what's good with, like, Jack and Logan? Like, they're telling me, like, crazy stuff. And they're like, what? No, they're lying. Like, let's go talk to them right now. Like, I will clear it up right now. And then we, like, all get together, and then it's just like, boom. I'm like, what in the world is wrong with this girl? Like, she's telling me one thing and then telling these dudes the other once she finds out everything from Mitchie or whatever. And she understood how everything was being mapped out.
And she was playing the game.
She was playing the game, bro. Like, homie hopped to Jack right away, whatever. I was cool with it. I was like,
because you know Jack's the main guy.
Because all I told her, I told her many times, I was like, look, just let me know how you feel, and, like, we can make it happen. I want to make it as easy as possible where it's, like, it's not weird.
Like, I can introduce and you
she,
to Jack.
Yeah, and she literally made it where it was like, oh, no, you're fine, you're fine. Keep doing what you're doing. Like, you're good. Like, I like you, whatever. And then she would go to Jack and be like, please help me, he's scaring me. Like, But I'm so understanding. Yeah. I'm so, like whatever, like, I was like, whatever you want to do, like, we could do, like, I don't care, like, you're not my girlfriend, like, we're all young, we're having fun, we don't care, like, it is what it is, you know what I mean? So, eventually, she, like, homie hopped to Jack, and it just started getting weird at a point, like, she was making things weird. Jack even, like, spilled, like, alcohol on me and my shoes and everything on purpose. It was definitely on purpose, accident, but it was on purpose, because that was, like, when he, like, started shifting his energy, started being, like, really weird to me.
And at then, this like, point, before she comes in the picture, this is just to say, be careful out there. This is what a girl can do to you if you don't keep your mind right. You guys are locked in on the content. You guys are dialed in.
Breaking records. We broke records on YouTube.
They're filming. They're putting out these shorts. They're all going viral. As soon as McKinley comes in the picture, not to say they're not going viral. They're still going viral. But to say what was going on behind the scenes on a day-to-day basis and the mindset towards content and life in general, what was happening?
Yeah, and like, it just, like, turned to making content, like, every day or whatever. In L.A., we made, like, so many videos. So when we came back, it was March, you know, everyone's partying, everyone's having fun. So that's when McKinley came. So, like, that was kind of, like, the vibe. We were all just going to party, have fun, yacht every day, whatever, this, and that. And at a point, like, I just saw how, like, we would go to the clubs just to watch Jack and McKinley make out on, like, the couch the entire time. Or, like, the table that we're at. Like, just make out the entire time.
Jack and McKinley?
Jack purposely was doing it to bother Grace. He literally even told me, like, verbally. He was like, yeah, bro, like, I invited Grace just so she could see. Like, bro, yeah. It was crazy. And I was like, do whatever, bro. Like, whatever. Like, it's not my thing. Like,
and what would you say? Because you're the real one behind it. Does everyone like each other? Do they like Dohertys? Oh, or
bro,
how is it?
I'll air it out, bro. Literally, Mitchie, every other time, she'd be telling me how she kind of hates it there. Like, she's kind of like this, wishy-washy. Like, everything stresses her out. Logan will be telling me how he just hates everything there. Literally just talked to bro like less than 24 hours ago, but like everyone almost like it's like the modern day team 10, and like it's crazy that I was in team 10, so it's like not it's crazier than team 10.
But behind the scenes, why would you say for the people watching, there's probably going to be like there's obviously a reason why everyone's staying.
Money, status. I even told him that too. Like I remember when we had this like big talk because things were getting like crazy and he was being super disrespectful to me. He told me I was replaceable. He told me a bunch of stuff. He said he wasn't going to give me the percentage anymore that we agreed on initially. Like, he just, like, turned, like, salty very quick. And, like, it's not my fault the girl wanted me first, bro. Like, I didn't even care to give it up either. Like, and at a point, it really came down to me telling Jack, like, yo, like, this girl's making everything weird. So either you pick me or you pick her. I made him pick. I was like, you got to pick one of us. And, like, I don't want this girl here. Like, I have every right to have authority in this moment and say how, like, I should say how everything's going to go. Like, if I don't want this girl here, she's not going to be here. I helped generate all these views. I helped revive his career. I have a say here.
And also, you don't want a girl like that. That's a different thing between the girls in the house. Everyone knows they're doing their own thing. They're talking to other guys. But she knew what she was doing coming into the house, basically not forcing her way in, but she was like, I'm going to attach on to whoever I attach on. She probably really did actually like you, but what do you think about her and Jack Doherty's relationship together? Does she really like Jack? Maybe. Or she
I'd say she likes Jack for like the money and like all the things that it comes with, but like literally like girls that would go and work with them, like new girls, it would always come back to me that whenever Jack leaves the room, McKinley would be like, I'm so disgusted by him, like da 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 da, like on that type vibe. Like it would come back to me. This information would literally come back to my ears. And people are like, yeah, I was just with them like last week. And once Jack left the room, McKinley couldn't stop talking about how much she hated Jack.
Is this after you already had left the
house? I was gone.
So this information comes back around.
Yeah,
so
it comes back to me.
Recently.
Yeah, recently.
But do you think they stay, obviously, because think about this. These girls are 18. Sometimes he waits till they turn 18. And it's funny because Jordy used to make
this girl threw me off, bro. She said she was a Christian. She said she'll never do all this stuff. And like, and at a point, the first day that she came to Florida, she literally asked me, she was like, do you think Jack's going to want to
keep that too?
She told me this once she got to the house. Kept asking McKinley. McKinley kept asking me this once she got to the house. She was like, do you think Jack's going to keep me around if I don't do the OF? And I'm like, probably not. Like, if you don't do it, you're probably not going to stay here.
Because she's not an actual girlfriend. Exactly.
And so for the longest time, like, she didn't do OF. And then eventually, it happened. And I was like, damn, he finally got her.
How'd it happen? I mean, that guy's persistent.
Eventually,
I'm not
gonna
lie.
Eventually it just happened. And, like, they've been able to drop some leaks and stuff and do all that crazy stuff. And her dad is definitely just like, oh, God. You know what I mean? Like, that's horrible, bro. Like, this girl's telling me she's a Christian, all this good stuff. That's why I kind of even liked her, too. I was like, dang, yeah, these other girls, like, they do an OF. Like, I don't really like that. But you're telling me you're a Christian, you believe in God, all this stuff. So I kind of like that energy. And then that just blew up like an atomic bomb. And I was like, okay, I did not expect that from you.
But when they're making so much money, and this is what I was going to say, these girls are, like, 18, 19 years old. Girls that age, they're normally at college going to parties every other weekend. So they're the fact that Dohertys, he could pay them whatever, and they're happy probably getting thousands of dollars because most girls aren't making that. And they're getting seen by everyone, and what are the things that people in general, not just girls in general, like, they want attention and money, and they're getting everything right there. So if they leave, they probably know, oh, I probably can't do this by myself, or they're afraid. It's like a modern day pimp, bro.
Yeah, and like the day that like I left, literally like no one in the arc, like a flood happened. Like there was it rained so hard that his Lambo got not totaled, but the interior got messed up. My car got totaled, and that was the perfect excuse to take all my equipment to my mom's house. Because, like, the day before that, I was talking to some of my friends, and I was like, I want to just, like, leave. I want to take all my stuff, but I just don't know how to do it without, like, you know, because he wanted me to, like, forcefully edit for him and stay with him.
He already paid you up front.
Yeah, no matter how he treated me, he just wanted me to stay there. And like, he said he was going to sue me if I didn't continue editing for him. He said he was going to sue me. Like, bro. I didn't sign anything,
but he paid you up front.
I didn't
bro.
Sign anything.
He paid you up front, so it's a weird situation.
Exactly,
right?
and he also backtracked on the percentage, so that's where like he breached it. You know
what
I mean?
Tell him that.
Yeah, so like he breached the fact that I was gonna get 20% of the YouTube, and at the time,
YouTube revenue.
Yeah, his YouTube rev was so low. Like at the time, it was only gonna be like 7K from like those 6 months, but it started picking up afterwards. And all he had to do was cough up 7K just so I could get back to like slaving away for him. But he was like, why should I give you any more money?
Which is absolutely nothing for what he was making, because the videos that he would make, and I think you realize this, you were making the innocent videos, but those innocent videos were definitely driving to the OF.
Yeah.
So you, bro, probably at like one of your videos made 10x.
Yeah. And what he would tell me is like, dude, like, don't, like, it, you're acting like you do all this stuff. Like, it's what I have to do on the back end with the OF is what's making the money. Like, if the views that I'm bringing isn't generating that money, like, he thinks I'm stupid or something. Like, if, like, bro.
Well, I'm not going to lie. He's the master manipulator and insane gaslighter. So, if you're smart, you see right through it. But if you're not, you'll get played like a fiddle, buddy.
That's he's good. He's super good at that.
I think that's why everyone, if you just look at it, bro, everyone who's been around him eventually leaves. Like, Nat and Zach, they used to be, Zach was his filmer. Those were best buds. We were all good buds. And I think he plays, and he could play it so well because he was young and smart. Crazy combination. Most kids are not smart when they're young. he was young and smart, and he looks super young too. So he can play like that card. But as he's growing up, he's like what, 20 now?
20. Yeah.
You can only play that card for so long before it's like, then it looks like you're just taking advantage of people.
I think he's like starting to hit that age.
But he still looks so young.
Yeah, I saw right through it though, because like the last day that like I was there, I had already like had a pre-talk with my boys and like what I was gonna say and what I was gonna do, because I've been thinking about this for a while. I was tired of all the OF stuff. I was tired of how he was treating me. I was tired of the tension between everyone. I just wanted to go about my own way. I already built his castle. Let me leave. You know what I mean?
Even the money? Like you.
I built him a whole team and everything. I could have walked away perfectly fine like I did, and he would have been just fine like he was. So I remember the day there was a flood. It was crazy raining. And I walk into this one room where everyone's at, and I'm like, yo, like, let's have this talk. I'm doubling down. I'm like, ready for this. I'm like, let's have this talk. And then Logan and Jack go into the Tesla, and they're like, getting ready for the talk to see what to talk about. And I'm like, I go look at the window, and I'm like, nah. So I go out, I get in the car, and I'm like, I said, we're having this talk. Like, let's talk.
Yeah.
And then so he's telling me I'm lazy, I'm this and this and that. And like, yeah, I'm lazy because I'd have no more respect for you. So why would I edit any video of you when all you can tell me is I'm replaceable and this and this and that? Like, why would I ever work for you after you say those things to me? So then and there, like, I kind of just put my foot down, and it was just, it was a weird day. But I saw right through it. I even told him, I was like, look, bro, I'm none of these girls. I'm none of these random guys that have nothing going for themselves. I don't care about these cars. I don't care about these houses. I don't care about the money. I've seen it all. I know how to generate it.
Yeah.
I want respect. Fine line. Like, my biggest thing was always respect. If you don't respect me, I'm out. Like I'm not someone that can be disrespected one day and then just like, oh, you're good. Like, as much as it says in the Bible to turn the cheek, like, I'm sorry, I have a hard time at turning the cheek. Like, I'm a smack at you. Like, I'm sorry, bro. God forgive me, but like, I'm from Florida, bro. Like, my brothers were on some like gang stuff. Like, they're crazy people. Like, not too crazy, but you know what I mean. Like, I grew up around that. Like, I keep it real. Like, I can defend myself. I know where respect is when it's due. Like I'm not accepting any BS.
If McKinley was never there, do you think you'd still work for Jack or no?
I would probably still probably I wouldn't work with him. But it would probably it would have lasted longer. It probably would have lasted longer. But I wouldn't probably still be there. Right.
Something
now
had to happen for you to do it, and it was like God's plan for him to be like, yo, this is way for Jack to get
like
out.
And that's like a flood happened that like messed up his car and totaled mine.
Like
and
Noah's
I got money
Ark
back
in real life.
Yeah, literally.
Well, yeah.
Perfect timing.
Has he tried to get you back since or no?
When I got all my equipment back to my house and I ghosted him, I literally just stopped talking to him and he got the vibe that like I'm not working with him anymore. He was like, oh, I need that desk back, that monitor back, the speakers back, all this stuff back. It's all mine, this and this and that. I'm like, bro, I generated you millions. Leave me alone. Like, what's wrong with you? So I sent him $1,500. I added it all up, sent him $1,500. And then,
which is crazy, bro.
That was it. Like, I was just like, I just didn't want him to have any reason to be able to get back at me. So
that's
like,
good.
Whatever, sent him the bread. He left me alone. And just like, it's just crazy. Like just how things went. So like, he knew I was gone. So he had to get more girls to like keep the money flowing the same way. So, cause he knew the content couldn't be back the same. Cause I had the content down like nothing.
You're dialed in, bro.
Dialed in. Nuts.
But if you go back to the very first message that McKinley really ever sent him, I'm pretty sure that was McKinley. She said, oh, I have to get my bread up or something like that. She wanted to get her bread up. So you could tell right from the get-go, dude. Like, I don't know if
she wanted it in.
She only wanted the money.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So
that was her whole plan.
What do you see them? Does Dohertys think that that's real or does he see through it? It's when you're in it, it's hard to tell. But because girls,
he probably thinks it's real.
Because girls can play.
She played me, bro. I was fooled.
Do you think she's real at this point, or do you think she still is like, I know what I'm doing?
I think you kind of have to play as real, or else things can get very awkward. Like, you have to play as real. Like, either side. Like, even he could be on that side of he's faking it because he knows he just wants the money, and she's probably also on the same side. They probably have already come to the conclusion that they're on that, or they're just playing each other every day. Like,
man, that's
crazy.
Weird.
Dang.
So weird.
Dang, bro.
But yeah, man, I was not lying at the beginning of this episode when I said this was one of the juiciest episodes of all time. We held back for a while, but JGL was like, man, I gotta tell this. So, bro.
Yeah, no, it is crazy just seeing like how it all unfolded and just how much money he's made. Like with the second or third month of working with him, he was like, bro, 10, he was like 100K today, like 70K today. Like each day would be like 100K, 70K. And that was just when we started. So
off,
like
off of
and
OF.
OF. And at a point, he literally had to stop saying how much they were making that day because he knew I'd be like, yo, just give me a day's rev.
Like one day, and he's
like, just
paid.
Give me one day rev, and I'm good. I'll keep going.
And that's only OF. He's not
so greedy.
Forget
bro.
About everything else, bro.
Yeah. YouTube
and the fact that he didn't even give you the YouTube rev either.
Not even, yeah.
Because that's nothing compared to like
what
he
was
making.
Exactly, bro. That's what I'm freaking saying.
It's so crazy how greed can change greed, man.
Yeah, and like,
it's so
with
bad.
A lot of creators I've worked with, like, I've noticed once I bring the ocean into their channel and like I bring the waves and it's alive again, their energy shifts. Like, I would say, not in a negative way, but for Jesser, like, I would say we would be having these like chill times where we'd be thinking of video ideas. It was very friendly, fun. And then he got this warehouse, and then it just kind of seemed like work, businessy, transactional, which is not a wrong thing, but it's just, it took the fun out of it. And then it just kind of like changed things, and they were growing a lot, yeah, but it just wasn't the same anymore, and it wasn't fun anymore. Like,
and that's
kinda.
We were talking, because we have a new editor that we just got, because we edited our videos for so long, which is a good thing, mm-hmm. so you can learn how to do it. And then we went through some editors, and we have one now, but what we were talking about is, and you were saying the same thing, it's key when both the editor and the creator are just as equally as passionate about each other, mm-hmm. because if not, if the editor's super passionate and then the creator's not, the editor is going to be like, dude, what am I doing? Like, I should be mm-hmm. doing this for someone else, or they're not matching. And if the creator's passionate and the editor's not, it's not going to translate. But when both are there, that's when the crazy combination happens.
With everyone I've worked with, it's always been start 100-100. And, like, the creator will see how good it's going. I will see how good it's going. I always stay at 100. I'm always trying to, like, do my best because, you know, like, I'm trying to get paid at the end of the day. And also, I do it for myself. I always tell creators that I don't do this for you. Like, if I'm working with you, I'll tell you straight up, I'm not doing this for you. I'm doing it for me. Because when somebody sees that video, I want them to think, oh, who did that? Who did that? Like, who? That's a good video. Like, I like how this is. Like, who is that guy that did this? Like, I want to be that guy that is the guy that did it. Like, for example, you see the videos where the text comes out of the mouth onto the top. Like, I started that, and everyone's doing it now. And also the sting, like, the little sound you hear in the beginning, a little ding, and then it loops. That's me. Like, I made that. And, like, a lot of people don't realize that. Like, little things that, like, add up, you know?
It's crazy. Like, the whole style that Jack Doherty be doing now, it's like, you are the originator of that,
yeah,
right?
Pretty much.
If he had royalties on that sound effect, it'd be over. You wouldn't be, you'd be done,
bro,
actually.
Yeah, that'd be insane.
Collective views would be probably at a trillion, at least.
Yeah, I call those stings, by the way. It's like where you take a song, you play around with it, remix it, cut something, you know, play with it, and it's a sting, you know? Sting. So people know now, because it's not really a thing.
But he loves teaching, loves learning. Like, he
I do love teaching.
Like, yeah, whenever someone has a question, he loves to answer it, and he'll go in as far as you want him to go. He'll go on for an hour for a little question.
I love talking about it. Like, for example, Mr. Beast, like, he only ever talks about YouTube. And I remember when I started working with Jake, I asked him, I was like, yo, like, how was your experience with Mr. Beast? And he said the same. He was like, all he could do is talk about YouTube. He talks nothing else but YouTube. And so I guess that's just how it is. Like, if you're passionate about something, like, you really got to be, like, delusional almost, like, crazy for it. Like,
that's why he's the biggest.
Mm-hmm.
Damn, that's a fact, bro. I get looked at like an idiot.
Balance is key in life, though, too.
Yeah. Like, I would say, like, I've been working so hard, like, the past 4 years of my life and 5 years of my life, where this year so far, even though I just hit 1 million subscribers, like, 2 days ago, I feel like I've been enjoying life a bit more. Like, I haven't been so, like, into the content as much this year, and I've been kind of just appreciating everything I've gotten myself, too. Like, my car, my house, like, everything. I just want to enjoy it for a moment, because, like, you don't know how much longer you have on this earth. And,
yeah,
like, if you're head in your phone every day, like, you're wasting so much time that you could be spending with, like, yourself, learning the creator of the world. So, like, how you perceive God is, you know, how you're brought up and whatnot, but you got to seek and you will find. So,
yeah. No, man.
Got to seek it. Can't say you didn't find it if you didn't look for it.
Dang.
Have you been looking for that voice, buddy?
I've been trying to find it for, like, 4 days now, bro. I think I left it down in Miami, bro.
Dude, it's crazy.
But yo, man, honestly, if you guys like JGL, drop a comment down below. All of his stuff will be in the description. And also, yo, this podcast was mainly about, like, who you are as a person, mm-hmm. and also kind of exposing the truth about the behind the scenes of Jack Doherty and what he really is like.
Dude, I want to say those text messages are crazy, bro. Like, I didn't know it was like that. It changed my whole
perspective. I've never gotten attention from a girl like that, honestly. Like, clout does do wonders,
bro. It sounded like y'all been dating for like months, bro. That's what it looked like when I was reading that. Like you're talking about she's going to come over and give you a massage.
Ring size?
Ring size is crazy. Yeah, I know. But yeah, no, it just all got messy. It was just a very messy situation.
But yo, if you guys want JGL to come back and hop on another pod, let us know. He's in town for a little bit, so this will be going up like 2 days after we film it. And Buddy might hop on, and we can talk about some other stuff, too.
How to hit a million subscribers in under a year.
Like, so many different things that we could go on. Shout out to Mason Lamb for hopping on the podcast. Health benefits.
I feel bad. I almost feel like I shouldn't even have been here.
No, it was good.
I feel bad, but, yo, whoever's watching this, I just wanted them to kind of, like, enjoy their
I mean, you don't know me as much, so it's like, is there anything on the top of your head that's still, like, lingering?
Nah, dude, like, we can just have a normal conversation after, bro. I don't care. It's just me. I just talk. I just ask questions. So, like, after the podcast, bro, we'll fucking kick it.
Yeah. And I think I think we should do a second one.
Yeah, no,
but,
definitely.
Yo, anything you want to say before we end it?
Or want to plug?
Vedit. Video Edit is my company. And this year, I'm going to do some crazy stuff with it. I've been sitting on it for, like, 7 years now. I probably have the cleanest name when it comes to... video editing companies, you know, like
video edit.
It's clean.
Yeah, I thought about it when I was working with Jake. Like, I remember at this one party, this guy came up to me and he was like, hey, like, do you mind, like, doing edits for me and this and that? And, like, just like every other person, I'm like, okay, I'm busy. But each time I turn it down, I'm like, dang, like, that's money. Like, I could really just do that or, like, give it to someone and then take a profit from it. And not necessarily I'm doing this company just to, like, make money, but I thought, why isn't there a place like Vedit where, let's say you're working at a set at Nickelodeon and you really hate everyone you work with, but you just don't want to leave because you still got to get paid and, you know, you're just stuck there kind of. You feel like you're stuck. Like, you can't
like
be comfortable in your
Jack
own
Cody.
Skin. Yeah, exactly. So I want to have Vedit as a place where it's like you can go and you could tell them what your experience is, what your level is, what your rate is, and then listed will be, like, things that are in your price range and you could find who you want to work with. You could see what you want to be. And I want to do crazy stuff with this, like, I don't want to leak too much, but, like, I have, like, machine learning AI stuff where, like, your mouse cursor can edit your whole video for you. Like I can tell my mouse cursor how to edit like me. So if you don't want to learn how to edit like me, like, I will just have a uploaded mouse cursor that's just moving around. And you just told it, do subtitles, and it's moving around doing the subtitles like me. Paste the video. It's pasting the videos like me. Like, all this crazy stuff. Like, I don't want to talk too much about it, but
it's going to be crazy.
Yeah, like, it's some stuff that Google would buy. Like, if you guys take it, whoever takes it, just give me some bread, please. But... I'll probably do it by then. But yeah, no, Vedit's going to be some crazy stuff. I have a lot of plans for Vedit.
All right, let's go, baby. Yeah. Thank you, Matthew JGL.
Subscribe.